Hello students, we are going to study Meselson and Stahl experiment. This Meselson and Stahl experiment is basically the experiment to prove that DNA replication is semi-conservative. Now the question arises that what is semi-conservative? Semi-conservative means half of the parental DNA is conserved in each generation. Half of the parental DNA is conserved in each generation. Okay, so what did the Meselson and Stahl did to prove the DNA replication is semi-conservative? So what they did? They did their experiment on E. coli. Okay, E. coli is a bacteria. So they did their experiment on E. coli. What they did? They grew the bacterial cell, that is the E. coli, for many generations in a medium containing heavy isotope of nitrogen, and that heavy isotope of nitrogen was N15. So what was the result? What was the result of this? They saw that the bacterial DNA, that is the E. coli DNA, became completely labeled with the heavy isotope of the nitrogen, that is the N15. I have used here the blue color for the heavy isotope of nitrogen. Here I have indicated that I have used the blue color to indicate the heavy isotope of nitrogen, that is N15, and I have used the black color to indicate N14, that is the normal isotope of nitrogen, or I can say that it is light isotope of nitrogen. Okay, so this is what heavy and this is what light. So very first, I am repeating what they did. They grew E. coli, that is the bacterial cell, for many generations in a medium containing N15, which was the heavy isotope of nitrogen. The point to be noted here is that it is not the isotopic form of the nitrogen, it is the heavy isotope of the nitrogen. So what they noticed, that the bacterial DNA, that is the E. coli DNA, became completely labeled with heavy isotope of nitrogen, that is N15. You can see here that both the strands of the DNA is actually consisting of the N15 DNA. Okay, now what they did, they transferred the labeled bacteria, that is the bacteria which was labeled with N15 heavy isotope of nitrogen, they shifted this bacteria into a medium containing N14. They shifted into a medium containing, come on, N14. Now what is N14? N14 is the normal isotope of nitrogen, that is the light isotope of nitrogen. So in the very first, they grew the E. coli in N15 medium. Then they shifted this labeled DNA right into a medium containing N14. Right, what they saw, now what they noticed, now we know very well that the E. coli cells doubles. Okay, the E. coli bacteria multiplies in every 20 minutes. So the samples were taken for each generation. That is, the first sample will be taken after 20 minutes, the second sample will be taken after 40 minutes, the third sample after 60 minutes, and the fourth sample after the 80 minutes. Why the samples were taken after 20 minutes? Because the E. coli bacteria multiplies, okay, in every 20 minutes. You can see here that the E. coli has multiplied, that is one bacterial cell have multiplied into two. This was one bacterial cell, this have been multiplied into two, and here after 40 minutes you will be able to see that the bacterial cells have multiplied into four. Okay, after 60 minutes it will be multiplied into eight, after 80 minutes it will be multiplied into 16. Okay, so after 20 minutes it is multiplied into 2, after 40 minutes it is multiplied into 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, after 60 minutes it is multiplied into 8, and after 80 minutes it is multiplied into 16. Okay, so after shifting the N15 labeled DNA right in a medium, or we can say that after shifting the E. coli in a medium containing the N14, the samples were taken after each 20 minutes. Okay, after each 20 minutes, the sample were taken. After 20 minutes, 40 minutes, 60 minutes, and 80 minutes. Now, first you must know that if we want to separate, if we want to distinguish between the heavy DNA and the light DNA, if we want to distinguish between the heavy DNA and the light DNA, so the DNA can be separated based on densities. DNA can be the DNA of the different types of the DNA, that is the heavy and the light, can be separated by using a cesium chloride density gradient. Okay, if we want to separate the heavy isotope of nitrogen and the light isotope of the nitrogen, then we can distinguish it by using cesium chloride density gradient. So the heavy DNA molecule can be distinguished from normal DNA molecule by centrifugation in cesium chloride density gradient. Now question arises that what is this cesium chloride density gradient? This gradient is used to separate the DNA of different densities. Now the cesium chloride is a water soluble heavy salt. Cesium chloride is a water soluble heavy salt. Okay, when the DNAs of different densities are mixed up in the cesium chloride, which is a water soluble heavy salt, and it is centrifuged, and that is when it is spun right in a centrifugation machine, then what will happen, that the heaviest DNA will be seen at the bottom. The heaviest DNA will be seen at the bottom. The DNA with hybrid density will be seeming to be present little bit above the heavy DNA, and the light DNA and the light DNA will be seeming to at the uppermost level. It will be present at the uppermost level. Okay, so here in this experiment, in the Meselson and Stahl experiment, you will be able to watch three type of the DNAs which are actually distinguished according to their densities in a cesium chloride density gradient. You can see that I have made the heavy DNA at the bottom, a little bit above I have made the DNA that is known as the hybrid DNA, and at the topmost level I have made the light DNA. Okay, so this is the heavy DNA, this is the hybrid DNA, and this is the light DNA. Now the question arises that how it was done, and by the experiment how we can prove that DNA replication is semi-conservative. So before the starting, you must know that in each generation you must know that 50% of the DNA of the previous generation is conserved. 50% of the previous generation is conserved. This means, say for if that is 100%, so the 50% of the 100% is 50%. 50%, then in the next generation you will get how much? 25% will be conserved. In the next generation how much will be percent? 12.5% DNA will be conserved. Okay, means you can see that in each generation, you can see that in each generation 50% of the DNA of the previous generation is conserved. Here it is 100%, then 50%, right? 50%, then 25%, then 12.5%. Okay, so after the 20 minutes, okay, if the E. coli has divided in 20 minutes, one bacterials have been multiplied into two. So in the generation first, when the samples were taken in the first generation, we can see that a DNA isolated was having hybrid densities. Okay, here you can see that one strand is containing what, N15 DNA, and the another strand is containing N14 DNA. Here also you can see that one strand is containing N15 DNA, the another strand is containing N14 DNA. So such a DNA can be called as what? A DNA with hybrid density. Such a DNA is called as what? Hybrid densities. Okay, so here you can see that very first the DNA was labeled with N15 DNA, but after 20 minutes when the samples were taken in the first generation, we got the DNA with hybrid densities. Right, and the samples were taken after 40 minutes. So what will happen after 20 minutes? 40 minutes. Okay, because E. coli divide in each 20 minutes. So what will happen in the generation 2? The generation 2, which will come after how much minutes? 40 minutes. In the generation 2, the thing visible is that you can see that the ratio is 1:1. The ratio is 1:1. What does it means? What does it means? That in generation 2, 50% DNA was hybrid. You can see that 50% DNA was hybrid and 50% DNA was light DNA. Okay, why? Because after 40 minutes, the bacterial cell have multiplied into 4. The bacterial cell have multiplied into 4. So out of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, you can see that out of 4, the 2 are having the hybrid densities and 2 are having the light densities. So we can say that in generation first, we can see 50% hybrid DNA and 50% DNA is light. Means we can say that the ratio is 1:1. The ratio is 1:1. Now the big question arises that if you are able to understand, see, I have drawn the diagram up to second generation only. But if the question is asked, in the exam that what will be the percentage of the hybrid DNA, what will be the percentage of the hybrid DNA and the light DNA, what will be the percentage of hybrid DNA and light DNA after generation third? You know very well the generation third will come after how many minutes? 60 minutes. It will come in 60 minutes. And you can see that the bacterial cell will be multiplied into what? 8. The bacterial cell will be multiplied into 8. See, in one generation, the bacteria have been multiplied into 2. In second generation, the bacteria have been multiplied into 4. So after the 60 minutes, that is the generation third, how much that is the bacteria will be multiplied into 8. Now the question arises that out of the 8, how many will be having the hybrid densities and how many will be having the light densities? So you must know that 25% will be having hybrid densities and 75% DNA will be having what? Light densities. 75% will be having light densities because we know very well that you can see that here the percentage is what? 50. So in the next generation, the percentage of the hybrid DNA will be what? 25. So after generation third, that is 60 minutes, you will get 25% hybrid and 75% DNA will be light. What does it mean? That out of the eight, the two will be having hybrid densities and the six will be having what? The light densities. Means what? The ratio comes out here to be 1:3. 1:3. That is 25% is to 75%. Means what? We can say that out of eight, two will be having hybrid densities and 75% means six will be having what? Light densities. Okay. Now, again, if you are able to understand, then you can tell that after generation four, the generation four will come after how many minutes? Generation four will come after 80 minutes. Generation 4 will come after 80 minutes. Now the question arises that after 80 minutes, the bacteria will be multiplied into 16. The bacteria will be multiplied into 16. Okay. So the ratio will be 1:7. 1:7. Now, what is this 1:7 ratio? 1:7 ratio means 12.5% DNA will be hybrid, because we know very well that after 50% we have got 25% hybrid. Then now we will be getting how much? 12.5% DNA will be what? Hybrid. So 12.5% of the DNA will be hybrid and rest 87.5% of the DNA. 87.5% of the DNA will be of what type? Will be of, that is the light type. Means this ratio is 1:7. What is this 1:7? 1:7 means that after the fourth generation, the bacterial cell will be multiplied into 16. So out of the 16, two will be having two will be having hybrid densities, two will be having hybrid densities, and the rest, that is known as the 14, will be having what? 14 will be having light densities. Okay, so by this experiment, by the Meselson and Stahl experiment, we can prove that DNA replication is semi-conservative, means in each generation 50% of the DNA is conserved of the previous generation. Not only the Meselson and Stahl have proved that DNA replication is semi-conservative, many other scientists such as Taylor and all have done their experiments on Vikshya Faba and all, right, to prove that DNA replication is semi-conservative. So keep watching my videos. Thanks a lot.